Rubber is one of the most essential materials in the modern world. It is found in countless everyday items, from car tires and shoe soles to medical gloves and industrial machinery. Despite its widespread use, most people have little idea about how rubber is actually made. The journey of rubber begins deep in tropical forests, where latex is harvested from rubber trees. This latex then undergoes a series of processing steps, transforming it into the durable and versatile material we rely on. The process is both fascinating and intricate, involving a combination of traditional techniques and modern industrial methods. In this detailed video, we will explore the entire rubber-making process, from the careful extraction of latex from trees to the sophisticated processing techniques that turn it into a usable product. We will also discuss the environmental impact of rubber production and the future of sustainable rubber farming. By the end of this article, you will have a comprehensive understanding of how rubber is really made. The origins of rubber. Rubber has a long and interesting history, dating back thousands of years. It is primarily derived from the rubber tree Hevea brasiliensis, a species native to the rainforests of South America. The indigenous people of the Amazon were the first to discover the usefulness of rubber. They would extract latex from trees and use it to create waterproof coatings for their clothing and tools. The world first became widely aware of rubber in the 18th century when European explorers encountered it in South America. They were amazed by its properties. Its ability to stretch, bounce, and repel water made it highly desirable for various applications. As demand for rubber grew, plantations were established in other parts of the world, particularly in Southeast Asia. Today, countries like Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, and India are the largest producers of natural rubber, supplying the majority of the world's demand. While synthetic rubber is now widely used, natural rubber remains essential due to its superior elasticity and strength. Understanding how natural rubber is made is crucial for appreciating the effort and science behind this remarkable material. How latex is harvested from rubber trees. The first step in rubber production is the harvesting of latex from rubber trees. This process requires skill and patience, as rubber trees must be tapped in a way that maximizes latex yield while ensuring the tree's long-term health. The method used for extracting latex is known as tapping, a technique that has been perfected over centuries. The tapping process. Tapping involves carefully making a shallow, diagonal cut on the tree's bark. This incision allows the white, milky latex to flow out. A small cup is placed beneath the cut to collect the dripping latex. Tappers must be careful not to cut too deeply, as damaging the tree's inner layers can reduce its lifespan and lower latex production. The best time for tapping is early in the morning or late in the evening. During these times, the air is cooler and humidity is higher, which helps the latex flow more freely. Each tree can be tapped every few days, and a single tree can produce latex for up to 25 to 30 years before it becomes unproductive. A well-maintained rubber plantation can yield approximately 35 to 500 kilojays of latex per hectare per year. Sustainable tapping methods are crucial for ensuring a continuous supply of rubber, while protecting the environment. Overtapping can damage trees and reduce their productivity, while poor management of plantations can lead to deforestation and loss of biodiversity. Processing latex into usable rubber. Once latex is collected, it cannot be used in its raw liquid form. It must undergo several processing steps to transform it into solid rubber. The first major step in this process is coagulation, which involves turning liquid latex into a solid rubber mass. Coagulation. Transforming latex into solid form. Fresh latex contains about 30-40% rubber, with the rest being water and other substances. To extract the rubber content, coagulants such as formic acid or acetic acid are added to the latex. These chemicals cause the latex particles to clump together, forming a thick, jelly-like mass. The coagulated rubber is then allowed to settle for several hours. During this time, excess water drains away, leaving behind a solid rubber material. This raw rubber is then washed to remove impurities and prepared for the next stage of processing. Rolling and drying the rubber sheets. After coagulation, the rubber is fed through rollers to remove any remaining moisture and to form thin sheets. These sheets are then dried using one of two methods. Smoke drying. The rubber sheets are placed in smokehouses, where they are exposed to controlled heat and smoke. This process not only dries the rubber but also preserves it, preventing bacterial growth and making it more durable. Air drying. Some rubber sheets are simply left to dry in the sun for several days. While this method is more environmentally friendly, it takes longer and may result in lower quality rubber. The result of this process is ribbed smoked sheet, RSS rubber, one of the most commonly used forms of natural rubber in industrial applications. Further refinement and vulcanization. Natural rubber in its raw form is soft, sticky, and not very durable. To improve its strength and elasticity, it must undergo a process called vulcanization. This crucial step was discovered by Charles Goodyear in the 19th century and revolutionized the rubber industry. What is vulcanization? Vulcanization is a chemical process that involves heating rubber with sulfur and other additives. This process creates crosslinks between the rubber molecules, making the material stronger, more elastic, and resistant to heat and wear. Without vulcanization, rubber would become brittle in cold temperatures and too soft in hot conditions. The vulcanized rubber that results from this process is what we use in car tires, industrial belts, shoe soles, and countless other applications. It is more durable and has a longer lifespan than raw natural rubber. Types of rubber and their applications. Not all rubber is the same. Different types of rubber are produced depending on the intended application. Natural rubber versus synthetic rubber. Natural rubber is harvested from rubber trees and is used in products like gloves, medical equipment, and high-performance tires. Synthetic rubber, on the other hand, is made from petroleum-based chemicals. It is widely used in industrial applications, especially where resistance to heat, chemicals, and abrasion is required. Different grades of natural rubber. Natural rubber is classified into different grades based on its processing method, quality, and intended application. Each grade has unique properties that make it suitable for specific industrial and commercial uses. The most commonly used grades of natural rubber include ribbed smoke sheets, RSS, technically specified rubber, TSR, and centrifuged latex. Ribbed smoke sheets, RSS. Ribbed smoke sheets, commonly known as RSS, are one of the most widely used forms of natural rubber. The production process involves coagulating raw latex, rolling it into thin sheets, and drying it in smokehouses. The smoking process enhances the durability and resistance of the rubber, making it suitable for demanding applications. RSS is primarily used in automotive parts, industrial products, and tire manufacturing. Its excellent mechanical properties make it an essential material for heavy-duty applications that require high elasticity and strength. Technically specified rubber TSR. Technically specified rubber, TSR, is another popular form of natural rubber that is produced by coagulating latex and mechanically processing it into uniform blocks. Unlike RSS, which is manually graded based on appearance, TSR is processed to meet specific technical standards in terms of purity, viscosity, and elasticity. TSR is widely used in the production of tires, heavy machinery, and industrial belts. Because of its uniformity and consistency, TSR is preferred by manufacturers who require precise specifications for their products. Centrifuge latex. Centrifuge latex is a high-purity form of liquid natural rubber that is produced by spinning fresh latex in a centrifuge to remove excess water and impurities. This process increases the rubber content and improves the quality of the latex. Centrifuge latex is primarily used in the production of gloves, balloons, adhesives, and foam products. Its ability to form a thin, flexible film makes it ideal for medical and consumer applications where elasticity and comfort are important. Each grade of natural rubber serves a different purpose, ensuring that industries can choose the right material based on their specific needs. While some applications demand high durability and strength, others require flexibility and precision. The careful processing of natural rubber into various grades helps maximize its efficiency and usability in different sectors. Environmental and sustainability concerns in rubber production. Rubber production has significant environmental impacts, including deforestation and pollution. However, efforts are being made to promote sustainable rubber farming. Sustainable rubber farming. Sustainable rubber farming focuses on reducing environmental damage while ensuring a steady supply of natural rubber. Several key initiatives are being implemented to make rubber production more eco-friendly and socially responsible. Reforestation programs. One of the biggest challenges in rubber farming is deforestation. To counter this, many organizations and governments are promoting reforestation programs, where rubber trees are planted to replace those that have been harvested. Sustainable rubber plantations focus on maintaining a balance between rubber cultivation and natural ecosystems, ensuring that biodiversity is preserved. Some plantations also practice agroforestry, where rubber trees are grown alongside other crops to promote soil health and reduce environmental impact. Eco-friendly processing. Traditional rubber processing involves the use of harsh chemicals such as ammonia and sulfuric acid, which can pollute local water sources and harm surrounding ecosystems. Sustainable processing techniques aim to reduce chemical usage and improve waste management. Some manufacturers are adopting water recycling systems to minimize water consumption and prevent pollution. Additionally, new technologies are being developed to process rubber using bio-based coagulants instead of synthetic chemicals, reducing the environmental footprint of rubber production. Fair trade rubber. Fair trade initiatives are becoming more prominent in the rubber industry to ensure that rubber farmers receive fair wages and work under ethical conditions. Many small-scale farmers rely on rubber cultivation as their primary source of income. However, fluctuating market prices and exploitation by large corporations often leave them struggling financially. Fair trade rubber programs aim to provide farmers with better wages, improved working conditions, and access to sustainable farming resources. By supporting fair trade rubber, consumers can contribute to a more ethical and sustainable rubber industry. Recycling and reusing rubber. Another effective way to reduce the environmental impact of rubber production is through recycling and reusing rubber products. Since rubber is a highly durable material, it can be repurposed for various applications instead of being discarded as waste. Recycled rubber in everyday products. Recycled rubber is commonly used in playground surfaces, running tracks, shoe soles, and industrial mats. Ground-up rubber, known as crumb rubber, is made from shredded old tires and is used in making artificial turf, road construction materials, and shock-absorbing surfaces. This not only helps reduce landfill waste, but also lowers the demand for new rubber, thereby decreasing deforestation and resource depletion. Rubber waste in road construction. Many countries are now using recycled rubber in road construction to improve the durability of asphalt and reduce environmental waste. Rubber-modified asphalt is more flexible and resistant to cracking, making it a sustainable alternative to traditional road-building materials. This innovation has proven to be both cost-effective and environmentally friendly. Repurposing old tires. Millions of old tires are discarded every year, creating a major waste management problem. Instead of sending them to landfills, tires can be repurposed into furniture, garden planters, insulation materials, and even art pieces. Many companies are now producing eco-friendly rubber footwear and fashion accessories using repurposed rubber, promoting a circular economy. The future of rubber production. As technology advances, the rubber industry is evolving. Researchers are working on developing biodegradable rubber and improving synthetic alternatives. Innovations like self-healing rubber and conductive rubber for electronics are also on the horizon. The future of rubber lies in balancing demand with sustainability. By adopting responsible farming and recycling practices, we can ensure a steady supply of rubber while protecting the planet. The journey of rubber from tree to product is an incredible one. From careful harvesting of latex to complex industrial processing, the transformation of rubber is a testament to human ingenuity. Understanding this process helps us appreciate the effort behind everyday products like tires, gloves, and shoes. As the industry moves towards sustainability, rubber will continue to be a vital material for the future. So that's it for today. If you like this video, then please hit the like and subscribe button for more videos. Thanks for watching.